So, we have our semi-base policy, and I can't wait to work on GNOME Terminal so that I can open up a shell in my GNOME session. Let's go. This is actually it. So, what we need to do is SE module DB again. We want to see all ABC denials. Oh, and this is the wrong one. SE module DB. And we're also going back into permissive mode because we're going to. This is still taking the same steps. And you'll see. So, SendForce 0. So one thing that we can already do is the following. So we have our TE file here, and we have our section for GNOME Terminal. Now we know that GNOME Shell is actually running that, so we need to basically run that with a domain transition. And we can basically use this policy here and then adjust that. So, paste that in and just change that to reflect us, our new scenario. So, we're G term, and I'll just use this one instead. And that's G term exact T. G term exact T. And we are G term. And we are G term. And this is G term exact T to G term. And then gterm exact is an entry file to the gterm domain. That'll make the initial domain transition work. Shoot. And we need to allow the role, the type. So this is basically our initial setup, making sure that this domain transition works. So let's just save and exit that and build that and load that into the system. Now we are having a typo already. I wouldn't be me if I didn't make a typo. And there's a gterm F somewhere here. And actually we did it also wrong. We need to change this as well. So good thing that T-Shell runs it on our behalf. Not Dbus. So good thing that we made a typo, else we would have lost much more time. Still typo. This one is stupid. Forgot to add a G somewhere. Keyboard is getting a little bit sticky. Not sure why. Well, I am sure why. I know why. So load that into the system. And then we're just going to log in and basically execute the shell. And then we're going to use the same method of policy writing as we did before. First, we take care of the domain transitions, for see what it executes, and then make sure that it executes that in the right domain. Then we're going to add some stuff, and then we're going to take care of file transitions and stuff as well. So, with that said, let's do that. Login user. And the wrong password, yeah, of course. Remember that we're in permissive mode. It's 1325. Let's just execute the shell. Where are you? Terminal. So we're in permissive mode. And now let's just 1325. I have a broad overview of what's happening a lot. Probably. Less that. Now before we do anything, we're going to look for execs. So let's just see what happens here. See, we're executing stuff. Let's grab execute. Really, that's just the only thing that we need to take care of. And also, GNOME shell, grab G shell, because it's also showing other stuff. G shell. Actually, G term. So this is what's happening. Terminal executes a shell, and we need to make sure that shell, let's have a look. Yeah, what's happening here? Actually, this probably, but this is not the first, this is just executing it. Probably check execute or something. This is not the first transition we need to take care of. We need to take care of this one, PTI helper. Or we could maybe just... Let's have a look. PS aux grep 10.12. How that looks. Yeah. So what we're going to do is basically we're going to transition to PTI helper. That's what we're going to do. And then from PTI helper we're going to execute bash. So that's the way we're going to do it. So what we're going to do is, where is the PTI helper? It's here. We're going to take care of this stuff. So let's do that. FC and add that, but add it so that we can use user live and then just make that so that we don't get stuck on versions. And then we call that GPTI helper. PTI helper. And then we're going to basically add some policy for that. GPTI helper. So back to our TE. And go all the way below. And then GPTI helper. And then basically just copy this stuff in. And just change that. And just make sure that this transition works first before we go any further. Take care of the transitions first. Now this is executed actually by gterm, as evidenced from the PS out and from the AVC denials. Actually, you could see that. And this is actually the same way it's done in the old GNOME. And this is the term actually executing GPTI helper. The term transitioning to PTI helper. And I'll make a typo again because of my sticky keys. And the term. This stuff, which might probably actually be not needed, but well, what the heck. And then we're transitioning to GPTI helper. And then we basically need to make the GPTI executable file helper executable file the entry point to the GPTI helper domain. And then we basically need to allow our role access to the GPTI helper domain. So that's done. Save and exit. Go back, make, and then install, and then restore the context. Execute, that's weird. So restore con, see if the context catches it, and it does. Log out and remove any content that's been created. So we need to do our kill and clear dance. And also remove the pulse audio stuff. And then let's see where we stand. MAVCTS 13 33 34, and we're clean. Let's log in again. And then just run that shell again. All right, and then just basically do our thing again. Unless that, of course, because there's going to be a grab load of AFC denials. I just want to make sure that the transition happened. And it did. So here we basically want to grab for two things. Grab GPTI first, and then also that's the first one, and grab gterm. So this is now gterm, but it's still executing stuff. So let's see what it executes. Grab gterm, grab execute. So terminal actually executes a shell. And then it runs some generic stuff that gets run when you run a shell, which is basically execute. So basically all it does is running a shell and the ID command. So that's fine. Bootloader read. So let's just copy this over this stuff here. And just put that into our TE file. This is gterm. And just add that below here. So it's doing that. Read, executed. This is basically just mapping it. Searching. I'll just add get attribute here. Then deconf, of course it reads deconf, and related to that there's going to be other AFC denials. This is also obvious. Get attributes you want to search if you want to actually be able to get there. This here doesn't make sense. I really need to think carefully here. Let's have a look. With regard to the PTI, we need to make sure that PTI is created with proper. Yeah, so let's just make sure that we have a proper transition. Let's just first take care of transitions, okay? We need to make sure that our terminal is labeled correctly. And currently it's a generic type, so that's a bad idea. But we have a rule atop for default user that basically takes care of terminal stuff. Yeah, this one. but it's not, that's for TTI and I need PTI. So let's add that one in, and then so change term G term, then from generic dev PTS change to user dev PTS. So let's just require dev PTS, require type dev PTS T, probably already required, but okay. Let's just not do that. Let's just assume. Assume, don't, let's not assume. Alright, and there we have some stuff that the user needs to do to the TTI. And that's basically this one. Actually, and this. And now I can actually see that dev PTS was already required, so I don't have to require that again. So and you know what? Let's just keep that out as well. Let's just do this. Tough. Okay, let's just do this. Alright, so this is the only rule that I'm about to add now. So I'm going to do this again. It's just simple with the type change. See if that happens. That's the most important thing right now. Although I really think that PTI helper does that, but okay, log off. And then just remove all the stuff again, kill, remove. And do an out search, see if we clear. quite clear, but clear enough. Let's have a look again. See if the PTS changed. No, it didn't. It didn't. Let's see term. Where is that PTI helper? So, okay, this was a waste of time. Let's do the following. I move this change, type change below. GPTI helper. Save and exit. Make sure that this stuff is taken care of first. Now we could quickly test that without logging in and out. Basically re-executing. /13:47. And it's still not doing it. It's still not doing it. Why is that? Because I'm also forgetting stuff. So this is something that just need to think about for a while. Because we need to basically declare a new PTI. And in the previously we just used other PTIs. So we just need to have a look in the policy. So I'll just open up. The IDE. And see what actually might all be involved. Ref policy, policy modules, and then modules, kernel, and then terminals. If so, here I have a term PTI term. Term login PTI. Transform specified type into a PTI type used by login programs such as SSHD. Term PTI. Term PTI. Where are you? Here. So make it a dev node and then associate and then these. So first we're going to add these. Actually. It's not needed. Why isn't it working? Let's kill the terminal. Let's do a PS out, see that it's gone. It is gone. And just 3051. Because it seems to be not going. Oops, and this is. Damn! Cancel. Permissive mode. Shit! It's a little bit slow, the system, and that's because of all the rules, of course. It slows stuff down. GPTI helper. It's just not transitioning. No errors. So why isn't the type changing? Let's have another look somewhere else. This is my previous policy. Three. Policy modules apps and then GNOME and then term gterminal find next. Decorations. So what do we have here? User PTI. Right. So let's have a look back. Term user PTI. That I already had that stuff. And then term create PTI, was it, wasn't it? Term create PTI. Yeah, we're, this is it. This is it. So it probably needs to be used in conjunction somehow. I'm just wondering better. This is the right. Thing to do. Because well, we'll see. But if GNOME Terminal needs to interact with generic PTIs, then it's probably better to do the transition on GNOME Terminal if possible. So clear up the whole shebang, kill processes, and clear, and then we need a clear, clean start. An out search, see if we're clean. We need to have a clean start here. 5.8. Probably not clean. Oh, we are clean. 13.5.8. Login. So slow. That's what you get when you can find a desktop. You really need a fast machine. Let's have a look. At least here we change now, but the term also fine, great. So that worked, but we don't want GNOME terminal to be able to mess with generic. Okay. Let's see how we dealt with okay, let's just go on below it first. Paste this in. Bootloader exec. How did we deal there with bootloader exec? So it's gonna, I'm going to be switching around a little. Bootloader exec. Where are you? This, I'm going to copy this. Oh yeah, this is mmap, yeah, that I know. And this, I'm going to get rid of this. Copy. Gterm. Because somehow whenever you run that bash, seems to be doing that. This can be removed. Then we will remove. This can also be removed. These two can be removed. This up a little bit. Let's have a look at the policy here. So here we actually domain transitioning on the shell already. Okay, so that makes sense. So let's do that. Actually, so that we need to do that first. So I've been getting ahead of myself already. All we need to do right now is transition on the shell. So here we have that shell. What is it? What is it? Core command shell DOM trans. So let's look that up in the core command module. And then core command shell DOM trans. Find that. Core command shell DOM trans. And then just write that in role policy. First this one here. Where the process will be my login user T and the source will be gterm. And then take care of the remainder, which is core command shell spec DOM trans. Shell spec then we're having some listing bin stuff and then a domain transition pattern. So let's look at the patterns. MISC patterns, domain transition pattern. Domain transition pattern, where are you? Here we have a domain transition pattern. So we can basically copy this over. And add that in. And then just adjust that. So what we're getting here is we need to allow our domain to execute shell exact T. And then we need to transition from the terminal domain to the user domain. And then we need to allow terminal domain like that, something like that. Alright, so this is the first thing we need to do before we go any further. Always take care of your transitions first. Because else you're gonna get stuff that doesn't make sense. And we don't want that. Now do we? We don't want to allow stuff that we really shouldn't allow, but that we allowed because we didn't take care of our transitions first. So that's important. Really important. Because if you do what I did, and I fixed myself, corrected myself, but if I would have done that, then I would have added all kinds of rules that don't make sense. So really just take your time, think about what you're doing. And like me, I'm basically browsing all over the place to figure out, because I knew something fishy was going on, but just didn't know what, so then I just go look it up. .4007. Better to take some time before you make the mistake than make a mistake and that you have to revert all that shit. That's much harder to do. Oh, I didn't even open the shell yet. Would be nice if I opened the shell yet, but we're 1408, so we're clean there. Hopefully. Let's just try that, 1408. Let's do gterm first. So as you can see, we have a lot less rules now for gterm. And that's just because we transitioned. And also, actually, let's first have a look at PSAUX. See how that looks. So here's how it looks. First you have gterminal, which runs the PTI helper and then basically the user domain in the bash shell. So now we know that it's actually done transition properly and that the shell actually runs with the user domain. And we know that the shell has the device has a proper type. So now we know that stuff works. So now we know that we can also trust the rules that we have here. So we can just trust them. Because there's no more executes, as you can see. Nothing is those binaries that were executed earlier, those were just not right. That was just not right. It was just wrong for me to add that. Yeah, but fortunately I thought twice. Just not logging everything. See that font cache stuff is also not logged. Search get attribute for font cache theirs. And then deconf is also a search herein. I don't know why it's not logging those. That sucks. Data home t, so then it's also need to read gconf home t, because else you can never get to data home t get attribute. It doesn't create anything, so that's cool. Gconf home t. So that's about it. It doesn't create anything, so we don't have to worry about that. Home routine, you might want to traverse home routine. These are some of the things that I think are needed, but also check out your user agency denials, because something is jetting. You better believe it. No. Till and 200 var log messages. Are you saying that nothing is chatting? No, I'm not saying that at all. Audit to allow. It's chatting. Oh, it's chatting. But we need to only do 1408. Stuff. So we have gterm to user dbus. This. then put your right. DVFS, yeah, this one, which is dual. Where am I? 4008 at SPI. At SPI, TVSD, TConf, basically all of them. And then back to go. Oh, I always get confused with these simple things. Alright. So now we have DBus taken care of. Let's have a look at PTI. So damn. ABC. Okay, now let's have a look at PTI. PTI is not much at all. So, let's move this to PTI. File system get attributes, read write stream sockets. Yeah, so let's do this for now, but there's going to be a lot of other stuff coming up, and this will not build probably because I'm missing requires in its RC warranty. What else? Wtemp. Now builds. Ha Now it's just a matter of fixing bugs. So basically what we can do is just start stop this mother constantly. So it's 20 40 20 14 20. Here we have some stuff that we need to allow for our user. And we need to do that with the, in the accessing part. So basically, tell terminate signal file. This is not still not needed. I'm not don't want that. Now let's just build that again. That's all we have, don't we? Oh, actually, let's just take care of this one as well. Gconf D2. Gconf. And it's a set attribute on what? That attribute on a file. Set attributes. What else do we have? Nothing serious more. Oh well, this yeah. For each domain, we need to make sure that Divus can mess with it. So that's. Where is dbus, and then just look at these, just add it there. Right. And then just build and install. And now we're going to enforcing mode to get all these ABC denials that you don't see in permissive mode. Sucks, that sucks. I'm not sure that has to do with audit D. So if anyone can figure out a way how to configure audit D to actually show everything, then your a solution for that would be very welcome, because now I'm going to have to do set and forth. Oops. Set and force one, and just go through all these AVC denials one by one. It now it's not going to start now, by the way. You can be sure of that. See? So close that, and we're on 4024. See what we got. We have a signal. That's not much though, but it's something. So gterm needs to send signal to PTI helper. Just go over this stuff again. and try it again, and then just as long as just keep doing it until it works. Just basically brute force it. Just brute force it. So 25 now. Now we're getting some stuff that we can work with. BTI helper, search def BTS. Get attributes. DCL wants to write to DCL data on the so where is DCL? DCL data, where are you? Somewhere below. DCL data, what does it want to do here? It wants to write to that door. That means that it's going to create a file in there, and of course that would make sense. This is allowed and this is not allowed. DTM wants to open PTMX. Where is DTM? PTMX, where are you? PTMX, open. Let's save. Build. Install. And try that again, see where that brings us. Shell's gonna write something in the Gnome shell there. It's a little slow. The system needed. Whoa, boom. That didn't work. So here we're going to basically add an attribute, use an attribute. Here we have a file descriptor that we can add right now. So add that here so that we know that it's related. And then basically we need to use a file. Let's just have a look. So devices. If I'm correct, we're dealing with devices. Yeah, devices. Actually, we don't really know.
this stuff needs to be allowed, so let's just walk through it. And here's the character note with the vice D. That's not right. There shouldn't be any character note with the vice D. That's a bogan fedora. G-term. Once the search config, and it makes sense, because you can't go to bconfig if you can search config. The shitty thing is that this basically, so I'm pretty sure that it wants to send syslog messages. Yeah, because it's likely eventually you want to mess with it. Let's just see if we can get some clues here. First, PS out, grab 10.12 to see that it really died, not somewhere in the background. It really died. Set a force 0. Try this again. 14.32. And let's see what we have at 14.32. Maybe we get a better overview of what it really needs. Hopefully. Not really. Not really. Nothing. Jesus. That sucks so bad. That sucks so bad. Just not showing us. So let's just have a look at my previous work and see if we can get clues. So if you look at D terminal, then as far as I can see, it really wants to use Pulse Audio. With system state, but I can't trust it. I can't trust it. Let's just allow it to get attribute of all device nodes. Devices. Get the device, get attribute of S. Let's have a look at that. Device D is now in FS. So this is. This one's together to look at all devices. Seems we label all list all devices. log files, set attribution, the build files, blah blah blah, generic this one is a bug, so we really need to basically take care of that. Should figure out a device to search device to allow login user gterm to device to there and then search get attribute, search get attribute, and then basically don't off, yeah, allow, just allow it. Or should I? No, don't allow it. Because there shouldn't be any in the first place. A generic device, the character device notes, device T T R R T H R file. Shouldn't be any, so why should I would I allow that? Okay, back to, we need to have an all device node, so that get attribute all device nodes. And I could just basically use my intuition. Close dev get attribute all jar new this one. So that's basically device node. So I need to require the device node. Require attribute device node and then just basically allow my login user gterm t device node tr file get attribute. But I need to do the same. Let's have a look at what else I have. There's also a block file. No, there's no block file. That's fine. It's only TR file. So let's just take this for a ride. And let's just save it then first. And it's not going to build probably because I'm using all kinds of types that are. Oh, actually, it does. Force to a one and then basically I'll search, see if it's clean. 39 and I have some stuff here for GPL. So let's just add that as well. Gterm. this needs to be required. Require process plus process get PTID. See what we got. And just go step by step. So this actually gives us something. This device. Let's just take it slow. So we have this stuff here, and let's get out to the search. That makes sense. Then we have that PTS there, makes sense. This device needs stable affairs. This one is allowed. This one, it's probably related to pulse audio. Let's just make it sounds and just see what it does. Search. What else do we have? So fix this device. Let's just go to storage. Good attribute, fix this device. So that's basically just this. Stable affairs, file systems, and I can basically it might actually search that. So let's just require these types. And also fix this device. And then we have init control. And and Pavlov. So let's we just need to basically do some testing here. That's basically what we need to do. Build that. If it does. No, it doesn't. And on type block device, yeah, block device, that's true. So block device class be okay file. And we'll see eventually what it wants with the devlog and init control and the other. We're at 1447. Let's kill this and start it again. Basically all at once, at least for now. Oh yeah, we need to allow this one to confirm to search. That's yeah. Actually yeah. Obviously that here. Get but let's just type something in here. Yeah, of course. So I can actually get enforce. That's not enough. So I can actually get enforce mode. Oh yeah, get enforce mode. Sounds. Now probably pulls audio or something crazy. Routy get attribute, that's not allowed. Yeah, you need to check mail, isn't it? That's weird that so where do I have that traverse stuff? And it's basically for getting mail. one more try, one more run, and then it's done, or it's done. Then I'm going to quit for now. Kill all. Clean all. Where are you? Kill all. This one, but it doesn't start. Of course, it doesn't start. The outsource of 51. Then we'll probably see if we can actually deny, execute PNT denied. Abort Atlas. See, abort Atlas is trying to do that, and all this other stuff is. Stuff that we can ignore, at least maybe, yeah. Seems all of it, yeah. So that's fine until now. Now that I just added, run the shell at 53. Load that up. So that's a file descriptor. Let's kill this. I saw it again. Same time, so that we can see if something is also related to closing it. These are denied on purpose, so that this doesn't work. Cut etc password. Permission denied. Cut bash. I see. Permission granted. So
yeah, that's basically it. So now basically we can just play around a little bit, but it's gonna provide some ABC now. So we have here top, well, no actual processes, so you don't have to, but you can probably deal with that in a nice way, because now we probably get a lot of get attributes of processes. Yeah, right, see, so now it's basically trying to get attributes of all kinds of processes. Term wants to write to their temp all of a sudden. I wonder why that is. but that's for a later date. But anyways, you can see that as soon as you start doing PS or the top, it's trying to get to the processes. But the nice thing is with these derived types that I can just basically say allow it to list its own processes only. So that's pretty cool. I could basically create a, and I probably will at some point, create a attribute and assign that to all the types that are prefixed my login user. And then I can just say, just get the process state of all my login user processes only and not the remainder. So that basically allows you to tune what you can basically, what process state you can basically see. But at this point, I just basically denied everything. So nothing returns if you do the top thing. And same with PS AUX. See, nothing is there. Let's see some other stuff. DF seems to work, or isn't it? Something worked, although it's free worked. This doesn't work. Free does work. LS proc, nothing works. LS for nothing works. No temp. LS temp also not there. Now, needless to say, you can't get to you can't even get to password. So why would you get to etc shadow? There's no way. So you pretty much you name A. Okay, that works. W doesn't work. Just shows up zero users. What else do you have? But anyways, the nice thing is that can't even get to etc password. Well, it still has a nice password prompt, so that's cool. So now, if you look at the user home directory, I'll do this once more, you can see that basically we need to allow the user some access to some stuff, and that third manager needs to go. But I can't remove it. I think I can try, but RMF third manager, but I probably won't be able to remove it. No, permission is denied simply because it's created with a user home directory type, and I don't have remove access for that type. But anyways, so we do have access to at least get the attributes of cache. We could basically also remove that so that the user itself can't access cache or config. Well, I need to think about what's best. So like with these, the user can't actually mess with its own files that he owns himself from a traditional Linux perspective. And the question is, should he be able to do that? And I guess he should. So that's probably why we eventually will allow him to get attributes and actually manage these files. Not sure. So yeah, that's basically, this is probably where I leave it for now. But at least we have some, we have one program that actually works. Although there's still a long ways to go. Now let's have one final look at the PS AUX, and then grab 10, 12, and then you can see basically what's going on there. So you have all these confined processes. And then eventually you have the user itself in the bash shell. So actually programs get run by GNOME shell, in the GNOME shell, from the GNOME shell domain. The transitions happen from the GNOME shell domain. So that's basically how it goes. And like I said, you can't run any program. So I can't, for example, run gedit, or any program, because the shell is not allowed to execute generic programs. For I'll just use gedit. Where is the edit? As an example, access is denied. Fail to launch. So cool. And well, you can actually log out without a problem, but you probably won't be able to click these system settings. Probably not. It's probably going to execute control center or something. Same for network settings. It's probably going to execute some other program. Sound settings, idem ditto. This you might be able to actually do that. And when you click screen reader, you'll probably need a shitload of other stuff. I could try it. Doesn't work. Access is denied. At least you can turn it off and on. So let's see what ABC denials we get from that 1503. Anyways, plenty nice stuff to play with and to explore and to determine. So there's no. Maybe it's too. And at speed, a lot of stuff gets executed all over the place. As in module B to silently deny. And then that's just basically it for now. So let's see if we can exit with typing exit. Yep, that works. And then just log out. One nice thing to see might probably be if let's just restore com rvf home Dominic and see what ABC denials I'll be getting. Oh, it's working. What ABC denials I'll be getting if I log in as a normal user. See how this policy affects the base policy of Fedora. There's a lot of data in this folder. But that's one thing. See how that affects stuff. In theory, nothing should be broken for normal users, but that's the theory. So let's just do center 4.0 for a second. And then just log in as, first let's determine that we're clean. We're clean. And then let's log in as a normal user. Now, ideally, there shouldn't be any issues now. Ideally. But that's probably not the case. There's probably a lot of ABC denials. No, none. Great. So that basically means that the policy is not affected by default. Right, so you could just install this module and basically that'll add a confined user and it won't break your existing environment. Alright, so this is it for today, and we'll resume some other time.